Hello, Vibratecos here again, back with more Pokemon Crystal Randomized version. Well, getting a Meowth was kind of a bust, but I mean, I can go back and try again once I have the good and super rods, and I'm getting the good rod pretty soon because it's in Olivine, which is just past here.
Right.
But I'm probably gonna go do that off-screen this time.
Yeah, because it's probably not gonna just take the 15 seconds like it did in this one.
What?
Or in the last video.
It took more than 15 seconds.
You ran out of the cave, grabbed the rod, and ran back in.
Oh, I thought you meant, like, the whole thing.
No.
Yeah, but that's why I'm gonna be doing it off-screen.
Yeah.
Going and finding the Meowth, I mean, not getting the rod.
Oh, okay. That makes more sense. Sailor Donna.
Yeah, because getting the rod is just going to take 15 seconds anyway. You talk to a person, they give you the rod, done.
Right.
But getting the Meowth is going to be an ordeal.
Right.
I really hope that I don't have to use the super rod, but usually the way it works is that the Pokemon you get with the good and the super rod are the same, but different levels.
Yeah.
So what I might do is actually just, like, skip a couple of these trainers. I'm at a good level anyway. You know, get the good rod and then go.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck. Okay, that didn't do as much as I thought it was gonna do.
No, it didn't. Well, you do have four levels on them and you're using a legendary.
Yeah. And Corsola is not all that great. Lady Mark.
Another Lady Mark?
No, this is the same Lady Mark.
Oh.
Remember failed recording and...
Oh, yeah.
Spoiled it again.
Sorry. I guess I'll have to make the League of Legends joke again. Mark plays, like, I think it's League of Legends with other people. It might be World of Warcraft.
By the way, the Mark we're talking about is Markiplier.
Yeah, Markiplier. And his character on there is a female, and he did a little skit the other day that he was dressed up as the female mage character or whatever that he is, and it was funny because he was, like, in a tutu and stuff.
Wasn't there also one game where his name was Sally McSaggy Tits?
Yes. When he plays Prob Hunt or any of the Gmod stuff, his freaking username is Sally McSaggy Tits.
Because somebody already took Markiplier.
Yeah, and then, like, some of the other people he plays as, or plays not as, but plays with, some of his friends, all their names were taken too, so there's one that's, like, Lord Tickle Dicks, and, Gassy Mexican, and Eat My Diction.
God.
It's great.
Those guys are just nuts.
They're all fucking insane.
The good kind of insane.
Yes. They simply went da-da-da-da-da insane.
Man, it's too bad that there's not a MIDI of that, because that's a thing that I could have you and Angel sing for. And you'd probably both do relatively well at it, because that's not so much of a singing thing as it is a voice acting thing.
Right. And I can do voice acting. I just lost my singing.
You're gonna have to get it back.
Yeah. If you don't know what we're talking about Creature Feature's song, A Gory Demise. You guys should go look up Creature Feature. They're freaking awesome.
Yeah, they have a few really good songs. A lot of them I don't really care for, but the few that I like, I really like.
Yeah, especially Such Horrible Things. That's an awesome song.
That's my favorite of theirs.
Yeah.
It's great. It's terrible, but it's great.
It's so horrible. Trainer Rachel. Just a regular trainer, huh?
That's rare.
Yeah. Was that even an actual class in the real game?
Yeah.
Was it?
Yeah, it wasn't just trainer, though. It was PKMN trainer. And it wasn't in first letter uppercase and then the rest of it normal, because nothing was at that time. But yeah, you could fight, like, Red's class was Pokemon Trainer.
Hmm.
And then there was also that one place in Viridian where you could fight a few trainers that had, like, all level 50 starter things as their Pokemon. And that was really good for level grinding.
I bet. Because you could fight them over and over, couldn't you?
Once per day.
Ah. God, I still can't believe Bloodlust friggin' knows Surf.
I know. It's great. Surfing Houndoom. Surfing Houndoom, man.
Oh, jeez. Ba-bing! Such darling Pokemon. I hate it when the sprites are outside of the middle of the circle.
What?
Lazy Mark! When the circle pops up when you're going into a battle, the Pokeball circle?
Yeah.
And the sprites are, like, a pixel off from being in the middle. It makes me so mad.
This is going to be so useful.
I know. Doesn't that move only have, like, 5 PP, though?
No.
Oh.
That's Sacred Fire.
Oh.
Surf has, like, 15, I think.
Ah.
But, like, that's gonna be really
useful. This is a good time to brag about my Pikachu!
But that's gonna be really useful for, like, rock and ground types.
Lazy Wayne.
Case in point.
This is a good time to talk about my Pikachu. He likes cosplaying.
Yeah, really. Blarg.
Wait, no, that shouldn't have been very effective. It's a Pikachu.
It still probably would have taken out a Pikachu pretty easily. Let's be honest.
I didn't get to show off my Pikachu.
No, you certainly didn't. At all. All the Pokefans are called Lazy.
Wait, okay, but that one and the last one you just battled were both called Lazy Wayne.
Were they?
Yes.
Huh. Odd.
That is weird.
Wow.
You battled two Lazy Waynes in a row.
Oh, how disappointing.
Such a disappointment.
I can just fucking obliterate everything with this Houndoom. I love it.
Surf!
Surf and Sacred Fire.
Sailor Noel. The sailors are actually called sailors.
I know. And the bug catchers are actually called bug catchers.
Oh, yeah. Weren't they actually called sailors in Yellow, too?
I don't know. I don't think they were.
I don't remember.
I'm not thinking they were.
By the way, what is Bloodlust holding?
Charcoal, I believe.
Ah.
Cause why the hell not? It helps.
Yeah. Sort of.
No, it does.
Well, it helps with Sacred Fire.
It helps with Sacred Fire and Fire Punch.
Oh, that's right, I forgot you have Fire Punch on them too.
And it increases it by 1.2 times.
Oh wow.
On top of the regular same type attack bonus, which is 1.5.
Wow. So you get 1.7?
Yeah. Multiply the regular amount of damage by 1.7.
Right.
Not increase it by, like, that much.
Well, yeah, I know.
Just explaining for people who might not.
Oh, yeah, okay. God, Chanseys have so much health.
They do.
Can't you, like, super overpower a Blissey with, like, EVs and stuff and get it, like, 800 health?
I do not know, but I wouldn't be too surprised. Because those things have a shit ton of health.
I know that pretty much the only use for Chanseys and Blisseys are as tanks.
Also, I believe Chansey has a pretty low special defense and Blissey has a pretty low physical defense, although I might have that backwards. But still,
like,
their HP, though.
Back when I used to do solo runs, I used to have a Chansey or a Blissey in my party, so that whenever I needed to revive my regular thing, it would actually survive.
Yeah.
And then I could, you know, revive some of my other reviver slaves.
Your other decoys?
Yeah.
Okay,
there went shoes.
Go away.
Yo, bitch, how you doing?
Yes, I know there are Ampharos over there. Quit rubbing it in. Okay, I forget which house the good rod is in, but I think it's this one.
That looks like a fisherman.
Yep.
Batch received. Good rod.
Fish aren't found in the sea alone. They're in just about any body of water in this game. Regardless of how small it is.
And you can find and catch unlimited fish in even the tiniest little bit of water.
Pokemon logic.
They just breed really fast.
Well, yeah.
Pokemon steps for the eggs. Or, you know, it takes a certain number of steps to hatch an egg. Well, Pokemon, each of their steps is 1,000 of yours.
What?
Because they're with their, like, parents, so yeah. They can hatch their eggs really fast.
What?
Yeah.
I don't know what you're trying to explain with that.
They breed really fast. Their eggs hatch really, really fast.
Yeah, but then you said something about somebody's steps?
The Pokemon carrying the eggs' steps.
That doesn't...
I was trying to make a joke.
It wasn't funny.
Because you didn't get it.
I think it just wasn't funny. Why would that be funny?
You didn't get it, so you just, like, assumed it wasn't funny.
Well, no, but, like, even now that I do get it, I don't find the punchline or humor. I don't know. You said a thing that doesn't make sense, but that doesn't make it funny. I'm sorry.
This is no place for playing. Well, too bad.
Takes out train set. Schoolboy!
This is no place for playing! These are my blocks! Mine!
God. This is no place for playing. Throws out dancing tree.
Normally he has a Noctowl.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why I remember that. That's such a random thing to remember.
Is this Pokemon Tower, by the way?
No.
No?
Pokemon Tower is in Lavender Town.
Oh, duh.
This is the lighthouse.
Duh.
You derp.
Well, I always just used to call that place the graveyard or the cemetery. So I forgot it was called Pokemon Tower.
Oh, that's what it is.
Men of the sea are always spoiling for a good fight.
Sailor Jill.
No! No. Go away. I will take my pill later.
Your phone's just like, but babies!
No.
Babies, though!
No.
But babies!
No. No babies. That's the whole reason that I take pills. Well, half the reason.
Exactly. It's trying to warn you. There's babies! Hello, Togetic.
I'm not going to spontaneously gain a baby in my womb if I don't take my pill within 5 minutes.
Sure you will.
No, I won't.
That's how Pokemon work.
No, it's not. Pokemon have sex and then they get pregnant.
No, that's not confirmed by Game Freak.
Bullshit.
In fact, they actually showed in, I think, Platinum how eggs are made. And just fucking Arceus is just like, eh, and just kind of makes it.
Well, that was Arceus.
Yeah. That's he made how... he can make you a Giratina, Lugia, not Lugia, fucking
Dialga.
God damn it, Lugia Dialga.
He can make you Dialga, Palkia, or Giratina.
Yeah.
An egg. But that's Arceus.
Yeah. Arceus doesn't need sex.
He can kind of just spawn things. He's Arceus. So I'm not really gonna go on that for all of them.
Yeah, it's sexier if they fuck.
Also makes more sense if they fuck, because they're not all creation deities.
Right.
Only Arceus.
But what
is.
They were trying to get across is that, like, no, stop saying they have sex. Arceus just makes the egg appear there.
But, I don't think that's what they were trying to get at. I think they were just trying to get at the fact that Arceus can create things.
Well, the guy that was with you was saying that, like, this is, you know, we're the first people to witness the creation of an egg. This is how eggs are created and blah, blah, blah. They were trying their hardest to be like, they don't have sex! But you put a male and a female in the daycare, they fuck.
I don't even think they were really trying to disprove that, because it was Arceus.
Right.
They were probably saying, like, oh, we're the first people ever to witness how Arceus does this.
Hmm.
Or something like that.
I don't know. The way the guy was talking, it just seemed like he thought this is how all eggs were made.
I kind of doubt it.
Batch. That guy's probably just never seen a Pokemon daycare.
That guy probably just doesn't know shit about how Pokemon breed. It seems like a lot of people in Pokemon don't know about how things work.
Yeah, we were so surprised. We don't know how it got there.
Yeah.
They done fucked. I mean, seriously, what other explanation could there be for two mammalian animals to have an egg? That sounded weird, because I said mammalian, but they all make eggs.
Yeah.
And a lot of them are mammals.
Or at least a lot of them are like mammals. I don't really know how that would work in Pokemon.
Not really either.
I still count them as mammals and birds and reptiles and things.
Yeah.
Although in some cases, I don't know what the hell you would call it.
Yeah, like Garbodor, or whatever the fuck his name is.
Garbodor.
Yeah, Garfield.
Go-Go Power Rangers.
No, Garfield.
Go-Go Power Rangers.
They're the leftover lasagna.
Lasagna sounds good, actually.
Hey, shut up. I saw lasagna in my freezer this morning, and I was just like, it looks so good!
You have to explain your diet again.
Oh, fuck.
That was in the failed recording.
Okay, I'm on this cleanse for the South Beach diet. It's a 2-week cleanse. You can only drink water. You can't have any dairy or bread. You can only eat very specific things, such as the meats you can eat are light meats, like chicken and turkey, or any kind of fish.
Or very lean beef.
Very, very lean beef, like the 93% lean beef, or whatever. And you have to be very sparing with the beef as well.
Occasionally, fat-free cheese is okay, but other than that, no dairy, no grains, no fruit.
Yeah, if you have fat-free cheese, that's not too bad, but it is still bad.
It's kind of pushing it.
Yeah. I mean, if you just absolutely can't go without cheese, get some fat-free cheese. But, yeah. And it's so hard. But it gets results. I've already lost 8 pounds, and I'm on day 9. So, lose about a pound a day.
About.
And 14 days, you know, that's about 15 pounds to lose. Almost.
Pretty much, yeah.
And if that's all you're going for, you know, then you don't even have to go on with the rest of the diet. After that, you can eat whatever you want, but it's all about balance. Like, you have to eat not too much of anything and a little bit of everything.
You still can't really eat whatever you want. I mean, you still have to avoid things like McDonald's.
Yeah.
Obviously.
Well, the diet says every now and again you can, like, splurge and do that, but not
as often as Americans usually do. Like, I used to get McDonald's at least, like, twice a week, but that is highly frowned upon. Now, I'll be lucky if I get it once a month.
Yeah. You could still go to a better fast food place like Wendy's.
Yeah, Wendy's has very healthy food. For those of you who don't know, Wendy's is ranked number 2 on the healthiest fast food list. Because they use fresh ingredients and they use actual beef. That's, you know, from the parts of the cow you would expect to eat.
As Chick-fil-A, opposed to some places that don't.
Chick-fil-A is the highest in the healthy food list, or healthy fast food chain. And Subway is number 3. Subway would be higher, but they offer way too many, you know, bad things.
Yeah.
That, and a lot of times, Subways are not kept very clean, and that transfers to the unhealthiness of the food.
Yeah, it does.
But they're still rather healthy. And McDonald's is number 2 on the unhealthy. I don't remember what number 1 is.
If McDonald's isn't number 1 on the unhealthy, I'm terrified.
It's barely not number 1. But I think, I don't know why it was considered, but I think Applebee's is number 3 on the fast food list.
On the unhealthy or healthy?
Unhealthy.
Weird. That's not really a fast food place.
I think they considered that fast food because you can do the to-go orders, but it was on the fast food list. It was specifically a fast food list, and Applebee's was on it.
That's weird.
Yeah.
Because that's not...
Also, I believe KFC is somewhere around number 5 on the healthy list. Which is really weird, because you would think KFC would be closer to the unhealthy.
Well, KFC's main thing is chicken.
Yeah, but they fry it, like, 8 times.
I don't know about that.
Well, not literally, but, yeah. I mean, I guess they're not nearly as bad as I originally thought they were, but, you know. So, things like KFC and Wendy's you can eat every now and again.
I really want to know what the number 1 unhealthy one was.
I can't remember. It might have been McDonald's, and there was something else that was, like, right below McDonald's or something like that. I just remember McDonald's and the other thing were, like, right next to each other on 1 and 2.
Would it be Jack in the Box?
No, Jack in the Box isn't that bad. I think that's number 4. It should be number 3. I'm just going to consider it number 3, because Applebee's doesn't make any sense.
It doesn't. Applebee's isn't a fast food restaurant. Just having to-go things doesn't make you a fast food restaurant.
Taco Bell is actually closer to the healthy part. And I believe Taco Bueno is either just ahead or just behind Taco Bell. I don't know about Cabana or Casa.
I got some rare candy.
But yeah, on the South Beach diet, it's all about balance. Don't eat too much of anything, get a little bit of everything.
Yeah. That, and also exercise, obviously.
Yeah.
In the first 2 weeks, you probably don't want to exercise because you're not taking in enough calories to do so.
Right. If you do exercise, make it light exercise, like jog a little bit or something.
Because if you're not getting enough calories in there, you've got, like, no energy, so you can't really be burning calories
and
that you don't have.
And it will make your body sick.
Wow, I'm getting really close to Jasmine, actually.
Yeah?
She's not much farther.
She's probably not Jasmine anymore.
Probably not.
She already saw that whole new world, and she was just like, no, fuck that. And she went and ran away and changed her name.
Oh, I really hope this thing doesn't, like, kill me with a grass move. I probably should have thought that through a little bit more.
Super effective.
Yeah, it's gonna kill me with a grass move, isn't it?
Pedal dance. Lovely.
Yeah. Yeah. And insult to injury, it's a critical hit.
Critical super. Well, you can just surf on it.
Nah.
fire punch.
To the face.
Right. Which reminds me, Captain face. Falcon hasn't been announced yet. Neither has Ness or Jigglypuff. Or Lucas, for that matter.
At least not as we're recording this.
Yeah. On the 11th, they have not been released yet.
Okay, that is enough for this episode of Let's Play Pokemon Crystal Randomized. In the next one, we continue on with the lighthouse, obviously. And until then, goodbye, sir.